You are about to receive a 6-hour storytelling workshop. In 18 minutes. I had promised to give 7 of the 10 keys that unlock your story to help you get your story off the ground and your listeners soaring to new heights. But I'm going to try and give you all 10, which means we're going to have to switch the afterburners on and move like a jet plane. Are you with me?
Yes.
All right, then. Here we go. Speaking of airplanes, it was a gusty August afternoon. We crossed the tarmac to the airplane we were going to fly on the second leg of our trip from good old Tacoma, Washington to Arapahoe County Airport just south of Denver. The airplane, a beautiful white Cessna 206, 6 passengers, single engine, a workhorse of an airplane. The end number on the side was November 1065 Victor, or what we call 65 Victor. The passengers climbed aboard and I climbed in the pilot seat because I was the pilot. With a clearance from Mountain Home Idaho Tower, pushed the throttles all the way forward, nose pointed straight down runway 12 to the southeast. And all 300 horses under that engine cowl sprang to life with a gutsy roar. Moved on down the runway and all 6,000 pounds of airplane, passengers, baggage, and fuel lifted off toward the clear blue skies. This was going to be smooth sailing, for sure. We moseyed across southern Wyoming and turned back. I looked out of the pilot's window and saw the ground of northern Colorado slowly sliding by 5,000 feet below. I listened to the drone of the engine. An old pilot saying that says, flying is 99% pure boredom. Now the other 1% can get rather interesting. I scanned the instrument panel and stopped at the 2 fuel gauges because they were both on empty. And just like when you drive your car and your gas gauge is on empty, and you're driving on fumes and you're praying you get to the gas station before you run out of gas, I was now flying on fumes and a prayer. Then I heard the engine cough, sputter, and die. I watched the propeller windmill as we coasted through the air. Can I leave you hanging there for a few minutes? We're going to step out of the story. Because at this point, I want to give you the components, the keys to help you unlock your story. And we're going to come back to this, and I want you to think of your story as well as you can quickly put this down. So if you have your worksheet, here we go. The 10 keys are an acronym, cleverly arranged to spell SPICE TRACK. SPICETRACK. I know. Spice track. The first key starts with S. S is for setting. Every story takes place in some context. Setting is where you are, but it's not just where you are on the map. It's what's going on around that. What is wherever the story takes place, what does it smell like, taste like, feel like, sound like? What's the context of it? Are you at a wedding? Are you at a political rally? Are you at a conference? Are you at a funeral? Are you in a hospital bed? Is it a wartime? All of that comes into the setting. So help me out. Name 3 things that were the setting in my story.
Airplane.
An airplane was part of it?
In the air.
Air, okay, that's good.
Out of fuel.
And what?
Out of fuel.
Out of fuel, that's a different part of this. We're going to get to that key.
Altitude.
My attitude at that altitude was, yes, part of it.
I meant altitude.
Rolling down the runway is all part of the setting. And you can see that in your mind, right? That's S, setting. P is people. the people in your story. These are the characters, and in most cases, especially as Toastmaster speakers, you're going to be the main character in your story. It doesn't have to be, but let's just say you are. Who are the characters so far in my story?
You.
Me and the passengers. And there's going to be a third person in the story that's somewhat significant, and he's the ground controller at Denver who's going to be talking to me and asking me if I want to declare an emergency. The characters, the people. Now let me give you a clue when you're telling your story. First of all, when you prepare a story, it's a good idea to brainstorm as many details as you can about your setting and the people involved. A page for each is good, but you're not going to use all that. But that gives you the details to pull out from to spell. Now I'm going to ask you a question. Could you see the ground of northern Colorado slowly sliding by 5,000 feet below? And in my workshop, I'll go around. Everybody says yes. I'll say, what'd you see? I saw dirt. What'd you see? I saw trees. What'd you see? Mountains. It's Colorado. What'd you see? Sagebrush. It's Colorado. No two people see the same thing, but that doesn't matter. Could you see the passengers in the airplane? You saw them, but if I asked you to describe them, you probably could, but you're making it up, because you don't need to know that. You only give the details for setting and people that your audience needs to know so they can fill in the blank. I think Darren LaCroix said it the best I've ever heard. It's like you give them a paint-by-number paint picture. You sketch in the outline, and everybody has in their mind a mental set of paintbrushes that they can color it in. That's all you need to engage them. In fact, you'll be less engaging with your listeners if you give them too much detail. Just enough so they can get the picture in their mind is all you need, and you move on with your story. So S is setting, P is
people.
Now your story has to start someplace, so the third key is the inciting incident. Incite means to start something. So this is where we start the story. You want to start your story as close as possible to key number 4, which you don't know yet, but you will in just a minute. I could have started the story with what I had for breakfast that morning, but you could check that out on Facebook. So I didn't put it in the speech. I could have described the takeoff from Tacoma and what that flight was like, but it has nothing to do. You don't need to know that for the story. So start the story as close to key number 4 as you can. The fourth key. So we got setting, people, inciting incident, where your story starts. Oh, before we get there, you know how most movies... The first 10% of most movies, 10 to 12 minutes, doesn't have anything to do with the story. Mm-hmm. You've seen Indiana Jones, Raiders of the Lost Ark. The first 12 minutes of that don't have anything to do with the Lost Ark. But that's what the movie's about. It has to do with you finding out about the setting and the character. So in that first 12 minutes, he's in South America before World War II, which is the setting then for the story. But what you find out about is where he likes to be. Jungles, wild places. He likes tattered maps. He wears a gun. He has a whip. He searches for lost treasures. He doesn't like snakes, but he has a cool hat. You know all of that, and you haven't even started the story yet. So that's part of the setup. The describing the setting and the people getting to the inciting incident is the first part before you actually get to the story part. Does that make sense? The fourth key is the crisis. C is crisis, or a challenge, or a hurdle, or an obstacle, something you've got to climb, get out of the way, figure out, solve. At this point in your story, your direction changes. My direction was about to change. I was going to need a new place to land. Something happens to you. It can be internal or external. In the best stories and in all good movies, you have both. What the character has to achieve and overcome and accomplish outwardly is the plot line. What he has to or she has to overcome and achieve internally is the story arc. So if you're developing a really good story, you can have both the plot line and the story arc, the external challenge and the internal obstacles that the character has to face. So this is the crisis. There's a Latin phrase, sine qua non. Latin people? It means that without which, nothing. If you don't have a crisis, a challenge, a problem to solve, you don't have a story. You might have a report, or an anecdote or an illustration, but you don't have a story, because this is the essence of story, is what your main character in the setting they're in suddenly has to face, figure out, solve, or achieve. That's the crisis. When you explain that, what happens, and the crisis in my case was, engine quits. So, yeah, direction's gonna change. The E, key number 5, is escalating crisis. This is the bulk of a movie. Something happens after you get the initial stuff out of the way, the story starts, and then they face this crisis, and you think, and then they solve it, and usually it looks like, it's gonna be a short story. But then, boom, they get hit again, and they start to try to work on that, and then boom, they get hit again, and boom, they get hit again. So I'm gonna do a little workshop exercise with you. It's a good news, bad news thing. Okay, so the good news is, I start a new job Monday, but the bad news is,
start a new job
Monday. The car broke down. Crisis, I can't get there. What am I gonna do? But the good news is, I've got a second car. But the bad news is,
it's in the shop.
It's in the shop. But the good news is, actually it's not so far. I could walk if I had to, that's the good news. So, starting out, but the bad news is,
it's raining.
You're all from the Northwest. So that's the idea. It's like the good news, bad news thing. We're about to, it seems like, okay, we can do this, but boom, then we get hit. And in good stories, you start your movie, the last thing, the last one in the escalating crisis, it seems impossible to solve, to overcome. And if you can do this well, your audience is gonna be on the edge of their seats through the whole story. You gotta find out, what happened? You ran out of gas? Did you crash? I get asked that, and I usually say, yep. There were no survivors. Which might have been the case, except for the rest of the story. Where are we? Spice. Setting people, inciting incident, crisis, and escalating crisis. Track. The T. Now if you've done all this bulk of your story, the T is the turnaround. Turnaround is where things get solved. It's the cure for your story. In most cases, in movies, you got a sidekick next to your main character. Somebody comes in. This is where the cavalry shows up. It's where Luke Skywalker, going into his final, inevitably fatal battle, hears in his head the voice of Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Luke, use the Force.
Oh, problem solved. And he uses the Force and gets it. That's the idea. I suggest that you not be the hero of your own story. It can work that you are, and you'll tell your story, but there's a real good reason I think it's better for your listeners if you don't, if you bring somebody else into the story. In mine, well, what happened? Well, I tell you what happened. I did this. Well, how'd you know to do that? I don't know, I just did. And I get that a lot in our workshops. Well, how'd you solve it? Well, I did this. How'd you know to do that? I don't know, I just did. No, you didn't. Think. And sometimes this takes a lot of thinking to come through. I wouldn't have known what to do. Can I take it? Oh, it's not you.
Uh-uh.
Oh.
Somebody left the phone by the water.
Oh, by the water? Okay. All right. Where were we? Oh, yeah, where were we?
Turn around.
I wouldn't have known anything. I wouldn't have known what to do, except for several years earlier, the first time my flight instructor leaned over in the trainer airplane we were flying and pulled the power to see how I would react. And I reacted. Poorly. Bauer, because that's my name, so he called me Bauer. When you lose power and you're going down, remember these three words, and in this order, dot, dot, dot. It's in the book. If he hadn't told me that, I wouldn't have known what to do, but because he told me that and I practiced it, I knew what to do. So who's the hero of the story? Did I get us out of it? Yes, but not just because I figured it out, because I had a mentor who had taught me how to do this. Now the reason this is significant for you is because if you put yourself up on the pedestal, it makes you look good, and you can say, I did that, what do you think? You poor suckers. You gotta figure yours out, I don't. But if I can say, look at, I didn't know what to do, and I wouldn't have made it without help. And I show you my vulnerability. Now you're engaged, aren't you? We all need help. We all need a mentor. We all need the cavalry to show up sometime, don't we? This is what happens in the turnaround. So as you're telling your story, try to think out, when you figure, this is how I solved the problem, okay, who helped you with that and how? That's part of the turnaround of the story. That's the T in track. R is resolution. Resolution is tying up all the loose ends. In a movie, it's only the last minute or two, maybe three of a story. It's amazing how short this part is. Because you don't want to leave your audience hanging in midair. So tie up the loose ends. Resolution. T-R-A. A is what you want your listeners to go away with. It's away. It's the takeaway. It's a pithy, short, memorable saying that you want your audience to go away with. A. I want you to go away with using these 10 keys to get your story off the ground and your listeners soaring to new heights. The takeaway is what you want your listeners to remember tonight and tomorrow and a year from now. So the takeaway is what your listeners are going to go away with. Q is a very short thing. Q is the question. This is not for writers, it's for speakers. So I suggest this. It's simply, how about you? That's the question. How about you? Has there ever been a time in your life when you felt out of gas and you were going down? Has there ever been a time in your life that I got to give a speech and I really would like to use my God-given speaking abilities to influence people, to change lives, to make a difference, to inspire, to encourage, to help people make it another day sometimes? Have you ever? How about you? That's the question. How about you? And the final C is challenge. So I challenge you. When you walk into a room and you look at the people you're going to speak to, consider that this may be the last stop for somebody in that room. Or somebody may be facing a crisis that you don't know about. The point is, you never know whose life you're going to touch or how. I challenge you, if you want to make a difference in people's lives, and I know you do, take these 10 keys, get your story off the ground, and get your listeners soaring to new heights. Go tell your story.